What's up, guys? For today, I've got a little bit different of a video. I'm installing a downspout rain collection system using a 55-gallon drum. For this video, I'm gonna go over how to set up the drum, including all of your plumbing, how to install the rain collector right onto your downspout, and also how to protect your barrel from getting algae. So before we install the actual rain collector, I wanted to set up the 55-gallon barrel. You can find these on Facebook Marketplace pretty cheap. I think I got this one for about 20 bucks for three of them. Right now I'm setting up one, but I may add another one depending on how quickly I go through the rain in this. So first thing you wanna do when you get your 55-gallon barrel is wash it out and clean it as best you can. If you're gonna be using this for home water usage, such as backup storage or homesteading, you're gonna make sure that you find a barrel that always held food grade material inside. You can find a lot of syrup barrels and things like that. Now the first thing we're going to install is the inlet port for their downspout. You can set up your barrel in two different ways. You can have a sealed system or you can have an unsealed system. With a sealed system, when the water fills up to the top of the barrel, rather than spilling out on the sides, it will go back up to your downspout and then down your downspout like it's supposed to. If you're doing an open top system, basically you would just cut a hole here, install some type of screen, and then the water would just fall into the barrel. So for the inlet port, I'm using a 1¼-inch PVC fitting with a barbed end. This barbed end is set to fit on this extra bilge pump hose that I got. The kit comes with the hose. It comes out of the box pretty stiff and not very pliable. So I actually just bought this since it's nice and bendy and it fits right over the end here. So once that gets stretched over it, this will be a nice watertight seal. All right, so I think what I'm gonna do is install this right to the left of the seam here. Let's go ahead and see if the fitting will fit in this. Oh, perfect. Yeah, it just starts to grab. So I wrapped a bunch of Teflon tape around it and I'm gonna seal it with silicone and it should screw in nicely. For the outlet fitting, I'm gonna be using a 3/4-inch water heater drain. This is gonna get installed as low as possible. That way we're able to hook up a hose, but we're also able to drain water out at the lowest point so we have the most water pressure from the water sitting in the barrel. Okay, so with the hole basically threaded now using the heat, I added some Teflon tape. I'm gonna do a little bit of silicone. All right, so with the fittings installed, the next step is gonna be choosing the location for the rain barrel. We've decided to put ours on the back of the house here. That way it's out of view from the street. And we're trying to get it as close to the house as possible. You have to know where you're gonna put your barrel first so you know where to cut on your downspout. All right, so we set our cinder blocks up. What we ended up doing was actually pitching it forward slightly. That way more of the liquid sits towards the front, which will hopefully get us better water pressure. All right, so with the bilge pump hose hooked up to the fitting here, we can get a rough sizing on where we need to place the diverter. Okay, so I'm trying to have the downspout roughly about right here. So what I did was I marked it right under the spout since this is gonna sit inside the actual downspout. I need to make a straight line across here, then measure up 6 inches and then make another cut up there. And that's the section we're going to be cutting out. So originally I was going to use a jigsaw, but I've decided that I'm either going to use my Sawzall here or I'm just gonna use a regular hacksaw. Or I may use a combination of both. I just wanna see how well I'm able to cut with this without getting near the siding. The whole plan here is to not damage the house in any way. So now let's get our first two cuts done. The next part is to insert the rain diverter. So I fitting it inside the gutter. So that just sits on top there. Turn that up. Okay, so with the top cap inserted and the bottom section inserted into the bottom gutter, we're gonna go ahead and slide the top cap down onto the bottom insert. So that there seals the system. I'm gonna go ahead and get everything cleaned up, and then we can work on sealing the barrel so we don't get algae. All right, so with the actual diverter in place, we're in the home stretch now. This last step is gonna be depending on what kind of barrel you get. If you get a black barrel or a blue barrel, you won't need to do this step, but because we have a white barrel, which is semi-transparent, we need to cover it so the sun doesn't come in and grow algae in the water. To do that, we're gonna use a 55-gallon black trash bag that we're gonna drape over the top of it and then tape it down so no light can get into the interior.
We needed the one more side.
There is no water, this is the biggest I had.
Ready?
Uh-huh.
One, two, three. Nope, I'm ripping it now.
No, I'm, yeah.
Need it though, don't we?
Here, can I have a little bit of tape?
I just want to put stuff.
All right, so with the trash can mostly wrapped, now I'm going to cut the hole for the downspout.
Cut the hole for the downspout.
Perfect.
All right, so after you've wrapped the can like a Christmas present with the black trash bag, this is pretty much done. The fittings have been installed and siliconed. The diverter has been installed. Now the last step is just connecting the bilge hose onto your rain barrel. So now I'm gonna go ahead and give it a test by shooting some water up on the roof and see if we get some water coming out the bottom. Okay, this is off now. There it goes, it's coming out the bottom. If I were to do this again, the one thing I would change is install my inlet port towards the back of the barrel. That way the hose would just be coming down along the house a little bit cleaner. But aside from that, this thing's gonna work. So there you go. That is how you install a rain diverter system using a downspout rain diverter and a 55-gallon barrel. All right, if you guys found this helpful, let me know by hitting that like button. If you wanna see more videos like this, make sure you let me know in the comments. This is something different than I usually do, but if you guys like it, let me know. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.